New chapter. Some unorthodox ways to deal with bullies. Let's face it, if you're a person of substance, you are going to get bullied in school. But instead of telling yourself that the bullies are just jealous, they're not, or trying to learn revenge telekinesis in time for the big dance, you won't, I've tried, it's hard, here are some more out-of-the-box ways to deal with bullying. Legal notice, none of these methods have been tested in any way, and I do not hold Rachel Bloom legally responsible for any repercussions in attempting any of these methods. Now, if you were reading the book, you'd sign and date on a below line, but instead you should say this oath aloud, and that will be legally permissible. Have you said the oath? Good. Method number one, get rid of the bully's need to bully. Step one, learn to forge your bully's signature. Then, when the school year starts, sign your bully up for as many after-school activities as you can. This also may require setting up a fake email address if the signups are online only. Be sure to give your bully something authentic, like CaliGirl456, not something that shows your hand like judgycoos@hotmail.com. Step two, after you sign your bully up for the school activities, create another fake email address for the teacher at your school in charge of the after-school activities. From this fake email address, email the bully's parents the following. Hello, insert bully's mom's name here. Your child has signed up for the following extracurricular activities, and then insert an absurdly long list of applicable after-school activities. Then write, please note, as your child took up a valuable spot in each activity by signing up before the other students, each missed day of each activity will incur a fee of, insert a fee amount here. If you go to a public school, $5, private school, $20. If you go to private school in LA or New York, $1,000. And then say, thank you. Upon reading this email, the bully's parents will be furious that the bully signed up for something with cancellation fees without asking and scream that, God, your bully is so selfish and this is so like them. No matter how much the bully protests, they had nothing to do with this. The parent will make them go to every one of these activities. Otherwise, no Lana Del Rey concert, Gaskin. Step three. By week two, your bully will be so exhausted from the constant after-school activities, they won't have the energy to bully you. When they're not falling asleep in class because they were up late finishing homework, they'll be away from school a lot between soccer, debate, golf, dance, Habitat for Humanity, or the Young Socialists. Hell, they'll probably even have to miss that precious Lana Del Rey concert to prepare an argument for mock trial the next day. Step four. Eventually, your bully will suffer a nervous breakdown. This will be another tragic example of how we're putting way too much pressure on kids these days. But it's awesome for you! Your bully will drop out of school for 6 months to go to a farm in Oregon where he or she will nurse baby goats back to health and learn the value of living in the present.